Hi, this is Vinod from Cholamandalam Securities. In this video, we are going to see how to apply a mutual fund lump sum option through cholawealthdirect.com. So it's as simple as that. You have to log into cholawealthdirect.com with your login credential. So I am logging in through my login credential. Once you have logged in, so it's very simple. Straight away, you can go to this option called mutual fund. Under mutual fund, there are two options, buy SIP and buy lump sum. So since we are going to see the lump sum option in this video, I'm straight away clicking this buy lump sum option. So once when you click this buy lump sum option, it tells us three steps, which is 1, 2, 3, and the first step is the how to select the mutual funds, and second option is to check out the same, and the third option is the payment option. So I'm selecting the all schemes instead of Chola recommended schemes or all schemes. You can select either any of the thing you can select. In all schemes, I'm selecting at present, I wish to go for a passive fund in UTI. So I'm selecting UTI mutual fund, and in category, I'm selecting all. And whether you can have a choice of going with a physical or a DMAT, it's up to you. Because I have a DMAT account with Cholamandalam Securities, I'm going with a DMAT. So here I'm selecting the exact fund. So UTI Nifty Index Fund is what I'm searching now. Yeah, here it is, UTI Nifty Index Fund. So then this folio number is not compulsory, but if you want to feed the folio number, you can do, but subject to that. Say for example, if you already invested in the same fund, this UTI Index Fund, the same folio number I can feed here, so that the present buying also will go into the same folio. Okay, so I'm feeding the amount. I'm just going with a 5000 rupees amount. I'm just adding it, and now it says that added successfully. So I'm going to the second step now. In this second step, the whatever the fund which I have selected and the amount is showing now, and I'm checking out this. So now I'm redirect to this payment option. Under payment option, it is showing my bank and my account number and the amount. When I click this, it takes me to my HDFC website. So in my HDFC login, I have to authorize the payment, and again it will redirect to Chola Wealth Direct website. So it is as simple as that. So at last, I want to convey this information. See, only these 14 banks. Okay, when you are associated only with these 14 banks, you can do this option. When you have banks other than these 14 options, you have to contact the Chola Securities RM, relationship manager. They will assist you on that. Okay, thank you.